Good morning, welcome to Weekly Singapore Stocks with Jonathan. Today is 22nd of April 2012. And what do we have for this week? This week on Tuesday would be the world famous Apple earnings report. After the launch of iPad 3 called the new iPad, now everyone is wondering whether how well can Apple go. Okay, right now Apple, after creating an all-time high, there's a massive profit taking and touched the 50-day moving average for the very first time in a long time. So would there be a rebound? Well, this is highly possible. Okay, so do watch out if you have short position in Apple. Next, what do we have? In fact, over this weekend we have the IMF report. Okay, not the Mission Impossible IMF. Okay, but this IMF just got new additional $430 billion. Now depends on which conspiracy side you're talking about. The bullish side says, wow, this is good news, Europe can be safe. If you're on a bearish side, they say that if market is really that bullish, why do they still need to put in so much money? So market must be really bad. So it depends on which conspiracy side you're on, the bullish side or the bearish side. But the price will always be the truth, will let the market tell us. Okay, next, in terms of calendar, this week we have FOMC report. Okay, FOMC economic projection and press conference going on early Thursday morning Singapore time. So this is going to be one very volatile week, because throughout this week we have unemployment claims on Thursday night. We have, well, basically a lot of news coming up this week. Okay, so it's going to be one very volatile week. Plus we do have a, if you're into astronomy, Bradley minor turn date is on the April 23rd. Okay, now I do not trade based on Bradley turn date, but this is just all the conspiracy putting in. We shall see. So far the major turn date on the 16th of March works quite well. Okay, now so what do we have? Remember, Bradley is just pure speculation. It's like fortune telling. If the fortune teller says this week gonna strike Toto and you'll be fat for the rest of your life, I think you still go out, and I don't think so you quit your job, right? So you still go out and work until you really strike the Toto. So Bradley turn date is just like the fortune teller speculating maybe what may happen. If it strike. If it doesn't strike, well, we'll still go back to work, isn't it? Okay, so let's take a look at the market. Market for S&P. I'll take a look at SPY as a ETF that gauge. Now, it's been hogging over the last close to 2 weeks. It's been hogging the 50-day moving average. While it's hogging the 50-day moving average, right now it seems to be forming a potential bear flag. Okay, this potential bear flag, do watch out and be very, very careful. Now, some people was also saying, yes, it also did seem to be forming a potential head and shoulder. Okay, so if it does form this potential head and shoulder, and if this is the neckline, and if we calculate the price projection for the head and shoulder, assuming that maybe it will maybe break down from there, that's the price projection, about 129, about 130. Okay, look at the 130 level, historical level did touch here, and historical level right here and right about here. Any more? Well, one more, right about there. Okay, so if it breaks the neckline, right now it is still not in play yet. I'm curious. If, let's say, this is the fall of the bear flag, and if it does fall, let's say right here, okay, we do have a minor support maybe at about 133.4, thereabout level, which coincide nicely with this level and the rising window. Perhaps. So 133.4 would be a bounce, and if it does go lower, potential, well, potential the head and shoulder profit target on the downside. Okay, now moving up, well, not much resistance unless you are talking about the recent prior high, which is about 142 level. If it does go higher, that will be the resistance. Going lower, the support would be about 133.4 and 130, thereabout level. It must of course first clear this level, which is about 135.9, 135.8, thereabout level. Okay, alright, now let's take a look at Hang Seng. Hang Seng right now on Friday touched the 50-day moving average, perhaps could be acting as a resistance, which is why I started to initiate my short positions. Now do take note, this is just a small short position. If it goes higher, I will initiate more short position. If it goes lower, I already have a short position. So like it or not, I do have a plan on how to trade Hang Seng, and I do have a plan on how to trade various counters. Question is, do you? Or you're just waiting and have no idea what to do? If you're waiting and no idea what to do, then perhaps you need to get yourself some idea. Alright, now it is also a Fibonacci 50%, sorry, Fibonacci 61.8% acting as a resistance. Okay, that level exactly, which is why I shorted that level. Alright, now moving higher, let me erase the line. If Hang Seng do go up, of course the window and the prior resistance is still in play, which is also prior classical support broken turn resistance. Now immediate resistance would be here, which is this prior classical resistance. Immediate support would be here, which is also the window and also classical support, and the next support would be right about here, 20,000 level. The 20,000 level right now would be at about 200 day and 100 day crossover. Okay, next, SET. Now if you've been watching my YouTube last week, I highlight that Thailand Stock Exchange nicely touched the 50-day moving average for the very first time in a long, long time, and it rebounds higher. Sounds very familiar, isn't it? Does it look something like Apple? Touch 50-day for very first time for a long, long time, maybe rebound higher. So do watch out, perhaps Apple could have a small rebound. Okay, now FBM KLCI Malaysia, finally it came lower. Right now Malaysia do have a almost confirmed lower high. Right now we need to watch this support in Malaysia at about 1590, because 1590 would be the low here, would be the resistance here. Perhaps it could be forming a support right here. If you hold on for a few days, maybe 50 day will be rushing to save this support, but as of right now it is a lower high. So the support to watch out for in Malaysia right now is 1590, there about the levels. Do be careful. Even if it rebounds a little bit from there, you still need to watch out to see if it does form a descending triangle. Okay, so do be very careful. Next, Straits Times. Straits Times right now, like it or not, it's been going sideways for 1, 2, 3 months. Been ranging bound for the last 3 months, ranging between the number 3030 and this number maybe at about 2900. Oh, about 2910. That'll be a nice level. Yeah, 2910. So if you look at the weekly charts, as highlighted in my website, chartingacademy.com, it is a possible rounding top. But this rounding top will not happen unless the 2910 breaks. So don't short right now expecting a rounding top. It is forming but not in play yet. But right now, it is a lower high. Okay, but right now we do not see a lower low yet. So support to watch out for, immediate support to watch out for, is this level 2945. Okay, moving higher in Straits Times, there is always that window right here that Straits Times so far could not pierce through. Okay, now next, banks. If you take a look at DBS nicely hits the 20-day moving average, acting as a resistance on Friday from the hanging man. However, in OCBC, it did form a shooting star together with UOB, a shooting star lookalike at resistance. So do be very careful. Banks right now are at resistance. In terms of commodity, finally, first resources after for a long time maybe could start to go lower. If it goes lower on Monday, Tuesday, that means we have a confirmation that it breaks the 20-day moving average. Now, however, there are some stocks at support. Look at Noble. Noble right now is at a Fibonacci support. So do watch out to see if there's a rebound. If it doesn't rebound, if support breaks, that means market is really bearish. If market still bullish a little bit, do watch out to see if this support will hold. However, do take note, if you're thinking about longing, you just have to be careful, because right now the price is below 20, 50, 100 and 200 moving average and you're against the trend. Okay, so together with Noble, Sakari is also at Fibo support. Weak support, but nonetheless is 78.6 Fibonacci support. Do take note, same like Noble, you are now below 20, 50, 100, 200 and the price is downtrend. If you're longing, you're against the trend. So do be very cautious. Okay, maybe a short bounce before going lower. So do watch out for that. Next, in terms of marines. Marines are also at moving average support. However, it did touch a few times, so perhaps consolidating before goes lower. But like it or not, right now it is at a moving average support. Yangtze, price action wise, the last three candles looks like a bull flag, short term bull flag. Okay, so watch out for Yangtze. Keppel Corp, if Keppel Corp for the next few days there's a gap down, goes lower, this is what we call a island reversal candlestick, and that is not a bullish candlestick. Okay, so do watch out for that. Sembcorp formed a shooting star on Friday. However, NOL price actions looks like it could be forming a bearish pennant, so do be very careful. Okay, now in terms of properties, in terms of plantations, we do have Indo Agri. Indo Agri formed an inverted hammer on Friday. Why? Because Indo Agri also close to the 100-day moving average and is also at the Fibo 50% support. Okay, so watch out for that. Next, in terms of properties, right now Keppel Land on Friday formed a shooting star, but it is a white shooting star. Okay, so now let me give a summary. Oh, by the way, one more, forgot. Global Logistics. Global Logistics on Friday formed a hammer. Okay, it's just a hammer with no Fibonacci support or any support. No, correction. Is a hammer at a classical support. Okay, hammer at a classical support. Yeah, just a classical support. So now, in summary, there are signs that market is turning lower, but there are counters right now at support. Right now, I have already initiated short positions in a few indices. If market go higher, I will short a little bit more. If market go lower, I already have a short position. So if you realize that I already have a better plan initiated and executing right now. Goes higher, shorts are more. Goes lower, I already got short positions, already in position. So in other words, looking at the position right now, there is a possibility that because a lot of stocks at support, we may have a small bounce before turning lower. Possible. But right now, it is not me that's important, but it's you. If you do have long heavy positions, do remember to set your trailing stop, because it may not be that nice. Let me show you a little bit on history. S&P. If you remember, okay, if you remember the YouTube that was in the early April, April 2nd, is it? I highlighted that we could be possible turning lower in US on the 6th of April. Indeed, it did turn down on the 6th of April because of the non-farm payroll, and then we have a massive sell down from that. Now, if you take a look, this date, this was April 22nd. Market start to turn lower on April 23rd. Could it be that history replays again? We shall see. Okay, we shall see. But like it or not, right now, as long as support holds, the market can go up. Price will not go lower. So watch your support. If support hold, market rebound. But if support breaks, market goes lower. Okay, so right now, time to be very cautious, not leave it to fate, because it is your money. Alright, if you'd like to find out more, always go to my website, chartingacademy.com. Okay, this is where I post all my information. And if you're not signed up for my mailing list, do sign up for my general mailing list right here. And if you'd like to find out more about Inner Circle, where I treat a special group, my personal attentions, do join my Inner Circle. And do find out from here how to join my Inner Circle. So I wish you all the very best. Be very careful. And see you again next week. Thank you very much.